My name's Nigel. I've just started my own cooking channel on YouTube. I've recently retired and thought, what can I do when I retire? I like fishing, but you can only do so much of that, especially in winter. Now, I always like cooking. I've always cooked quite a lot at home when I've had the chance, but working full time, you don't get much chance. So I'm going to do a lot of cooking now. Hopefully, you'll join me on this journey. I'll be doing sweet dishes, savory dishes, baked dishes. I'll even try some I've never tried before. So that would be interesting. Now, I'm not expecting to be perfect. When I accept my first few videos will be mistakes of full of mistakes like that one. And also, because I'll be cooking, once you start mixing things, unfortunately, you can't retake it. You can't say, hang on, start again, because it's all mixed up and you're a bit stuck, really. So hopefully, it will all go okay. Hopefully, you will join me on this journey. And hopefully, I can produce some good dishes for you that we'll also try at home and you will enjoy. If there's also any you'd like me to try, just please leave them in the comments and I'll give it a shot and see what happens. So, my first one video is actually going to be my own version of a Christmas cake I've been making for about 10 years. There's a few differences I've made to basic Christmas cake recipes, which people might notice. For starters, no candied peel. There's extra glazed cherries, extra chopped walnuts. That's just the way I've done it, the way I prefer it. So, anyway, enough waffling. Let's get cracking. Let's get in that kitchen, rattle those pots and pans, and see what we can come up with. Hi there, it's Nigel again. Today, I'm going to do my own version of Christmas cake. Now, this is a mixture of various different recipes I've amended over the years to get what I actually like. So let's go through what we've actually got here. So in the first one, I've got 450 grams of currants, 175 grams of sultanas, 175 grams of raisins. Now that has actually been soaking in a container for about 10 days with 200 ml of brandy. So you can soak it a bit longer if you want a stronger flavour. Now in the metal bowl there, I've got 225 grams of sifted plain flour, half a teaspoon of salt, half a teaspoonful of grated nutmeg, 1 teaspoonful of mixed spice, 1 teaspoonful of ginger, and half a teaspoonful of cinnamon. And now in the bowl in the middle here, I've actually got 225 grams of butter and 225 grams of soft brown sugar. And over here, I've got 4 large eggs that have been beaten. Got 100 grams of glacé cherries over there, and that's double what you normally use. In the bowl at the front there, we have got the zest of 1 orange, 1 lemon, also 100 grams of chopped almonds. I've put double the amount of almonds in. The recipe used to say 50 grams. I've done 100 because I like a bit more nutty bite to it. A teaspoonful of black treacle as well. So I'm going to crack on and then we'll see what we do. So what we've got to do first of all is we've got to beat up this mixture of butter and soft brown sugar so it's nice and soft. Oh, I've got to get the spoons out. So we just need to get that beaten up. Grease through paper around the side and on the bottom. So that's all done nicely. So let's give that a rest there. So what we now do, we then fold in the mixture here. I need another spoon, just bear with me. So now the egg mixture, which is 4 large eggs, we just beat that into the flour and all the spices there. Give that a good mix up. I've been making this all messy, but I've been making this cake now on and off every Christmas for about 4 or 10 years, I reckon now. So it normally comes out okay, so I've never had any issues with it yet. Hopefully, I won't this time either. So that's done. Beat the eggs into that mixture. Then what we do now, we are just going to fold all this soaked fruit and brandy into that flour mixture. Wipe that in there like that, and give that a good mix up. You can, of course, do this in a very large mixer if you've actually got one. Unfortunately, I only possess a hand mixer. So let's get this mixed up for you. There is quite a lot of fruit in this cake. So then we've done that, then we add the sugar and the butter mixture into there. Then also the zest of orange lemon, the chopped nuts. Now the glazed cherries, I actually put them into quarters. So it's 100 grams there instead of the usual 50. But as you'll notice, I actually haven't put any candied peel in this recipe. I don't like candied peel, so I've not put them in my cakes for ever since I've been doing this cake. Right, so I'm going to keep that all mixed up for you now, and I'll come back to you when it's all mixed up then.
One eternity later.
Right, so nearly mixed this up. But you end up armed with arms like Popeye mixing this. It is a lot of hard work, of course, mixing this mix up. Unless, of course, you've got a decent mixer that won't break down because it's quite a thick mixture. So that's come to the end of mixing. Now all that fruit is lovely mixed in and blended into that mixture there. So now we get our 8-inch dish. Now you can use a square dish if you want. I prefer round. And we just spoon that mixture now into that cake tin. It is a cake tin that's got a push-up bottom, so it will be easy to get out. And they are quite good. Now, when it just started, I just recently retired, and it's just given me a bit more time to do a bit more cooking. So I do like cooking. So, and funny enough, I've actually just ordered some cooking stuff on Temu today. That takes about 10 days to get here, so when that gets delivered, I will actually show you what I've ordered and let you know if it's any good. It does work out cheap because I've recently been to my local store that does all cake utensils, dishes, etc. It actually does work out much cheaper than buying it local. Unfortunately, I mean, yeah, you should always support local, but unfortunately, when you're looking at money. And they also didn't have some of the things I actually ordered in this shop. And unfortunately, we don't have many shops in this area anymore. So that's done. Next bit, of course, is going to be the washing up, which we all dread, of course. So let me just get this pushed down for you. I push it to all corners. And then what you're going to do, we'll push that to all corners of the cake tin. Now that fills that up nicely. So I've got plenty of bowls which I'm going to be able to, as we used to say as kids, have liquors from. No doubt a lot of you remember the days when you used to say to your mum when she was cooking, "Oh, can I have liquors? It's my turn." You used to fight with your brothers and sisters whose turn it was to lick the bowl out. But whether that happens these days, I actually don't know, to be honest. So that's all done for you now. Now what you now do, you get a bit of greaseproof paper, you put a bit on the top there to cover it, and then put a hole of about 50p in top, so that it's just protecting that while it's cooking. So I'm going to wrap this over. Just gives it a bit of extra protection while it's cooking. So put that in there like. You don't need to be too fussed when you're putting this top on. You just put it all in like that. Now this is going to take about 4.5 hours to cook. So what I would suggest, put it on the lowest shelf in the oven at gas mark one. Put it in, don't open that door for at least 4 hours. You don't want to keep opening the door, check it. So wait 4 hours, then check it after 4 hours. If it needs a bit extra, then you can put it back in for an extra 15, 20 minutes. So that's going into the oven now. Let's put that there we go, and I'll come back to you in about 4 or 5 hours' time. Okay, thank you. Yep, that looks nice and done. Nice and firm. So, what I'll do now, I'll let that cool down. And then once it's cooled down, I'll prick the top and underneath with a darning needle or a cocktail stick. And I will then brush brandy over that. I will then wrap it up in double greaseproof paper and foil and put it away for a week. I'll get it in a week's time. I'll feed it again with brandy, top and bottom, the same thing. Then I'll wrap it up again for another week. Once that's done, I will then get it out and I will then put marzipan and icing on it to complete it. Now, I will come back to you when I do that because the first time ever I've actually got to make my own marzipan because I cannot find it anywhere where I am. So, anyway, there we go. So, there we go. So anyway, that's the Christmas cakes. I hope you enjoyed that video. I will come back and do another one in a few weeks' time when it's ready to be iced. So I will be making my own marzipan, something I've never done before. So fingers crossed that works. And then it'll be ready for Christmas once it's done and iced as well. So like I say, hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you want to make this Christmas cake. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.